Have you ever noticed how a song can transport you back in time? This is Tammy with Nurseminder, and we're looking at the temporal lobe functions in a minute. Maybe just a smidge more today. Now, the temporal lobe gets its name because of where it is in the brain. It's on both the right and left side, right by your temples. So that helps you recognize where it is. It also involves the ear, which means it's located near the ear, which means it's our auditory processing center. So it's taking in all the richness of the sounds in our environment, and it helps us to identify what those sounds are and attach meaning to them. It's how you know that the front doorbell is ringing and not the back doorbell. Now, when we look at the word temporal, the last four letters, oral, is another clue for us. Oral is reflective of speech. It helps us form our words, but it also helps us to understand when others are speaking to us. And here's the greatest thing about the temporal lobe. It's not just auditory processing. It works with other parts of your brain in order to help make sense of the visual stimulation as well, so written word. Now, O stands for objects. The temporal lobe is where everything is processed to help give a meaning to the things that we see in the world. So visually seeing something is not enough. The temporal lobe is actually responsible for giving and attaching a meaning and understanding. That's how we know a bottle is a bottle and not a book. R is for recall. Think long-term memory. The temporal lobe is also involved in taking our memories and storing them into our long-term. A is for auditory processing. So that's all the sounds and the speech. And then L is for language. The other clue there is written, spoken, and our own formation of words. Follow for more.